I am Diana De La Cruz, also known as Girl Nature 707. I am here with a review on the Cora Organics body oil and the face oil that recently came out, I would say about a month ago. So it's summertime, we want to glow. Also later on in the review, I will talk about the luxurious rosehip oil that the Cora line also carries. So stay tuned for that and let's get started. I also want to quickly mention that I have used around 95% of the Cora Organics line. I've just been using it for a few years now, so I am going to link actually some videos related to the Cora line at your interest. This was the first thing that actually caught my eye. I have used their other rosehip body oil. I checked on the website, it looks like they're discontinued, but so no need to really talk about this one. It's just rosehip oil. This is the Noni Glow Body Oil, and it's certified organic. It has rosehip oil, pomegranate oil to hydrate, illuminate, and tone the texture of your skin. I will say that the smell is very subtle. It's not too offending. I actually do like it for a body oil. It is 3.38 fluor. I will knock it a bit because I wish it was just a little bit bigger. I feel like I use it only maybe a couple times a week. I really want to use it every single day, but I know if I do, it's just gonna be gone before the month is over. So I wish it could have been a little bit bigger just to last me the full month. It has rose gold lining here at the pump. It locks and opens. The bottle is glass, so it's really nice and of quality. It is 6 months before it expires. Now, using a bunch of the Cora line, you do sometimes want to use things before the 6 months, maybe 5 months. Sometimes things last a little bit longer, but you'll know by colors and smells, especially the smells. So just make sure, like if you use the Cora line, just make sure you're using your products very consistently because you don't want to waste your money. Texture. It's just really silky on the skin. I like the smell. It's very subtle. I'm pretty sensitive to smells, so I really don't like too much of the smells. Everything is natural within plant oils, so if you like plant essential oils, it kind of smells like that, but like very subtle. I love the essential oils. It absorbs very nicely, especially after you get out the shower. It really absorbs into the skin. If your skin is slightly a little bit damp, works even better. So I would repurchase it, but I would just have to realize that it's not gonna last me that long. I think in the sun, you get like a nice subtle sheen. It's a real nice, natural, subtle glow. It's not like highlighter on fleek. It looks nice. It feels nice on the skin. It's not oily on the skin. I'd rather use a body oil than body lotion at times. If your skin is still a little bit dry after this, I would recommend adding, you know, body lotion on top of this for even more moisture. The Cora line also has an awesome body exfoliator that I love so much. So if you use that, then you use this, it's so nice, believe me.
Yes, and it glides a lot. And then this is like 5.9. See, that's why I need something like that in the body oil. Give me that, Cora.
Okay, moving on to the face oil by Cora Organics. Now I started off at Sephora with, I actually bought the body oil and then I got a little sample of the face oil, which after using a whole bunch of it, I was surprised how much I actually liked it. It was good. I didn't want to use any other product, any other moisturizer. So then I decided, you know, to upgrade to a bigger size. It has many similar oils as the Body Glow, Noni Extract, Rosehip Oil, Pomegranate, Buckhorn Oils, and just a whole bunch of other stuff. I'll let you read the ingredients. I definitely experienced like this plumpness in the skin, especially when I would wake up in the morning. I like how it just kind of fills everything up, plumps your skin, and it doesn't leave your skin so, oily. Like if you leave it a little damp, maybe after your toner or just washing your face and you apply it on your skin, especially for my acne prone or combination skin, P people out there. If you do that, it kind of absorbs even more and you don't get like that greasy feeling. But I'm surprised, like it just feels very lightweight on the skin. I would also recommend if you do use oils, I mean, it's good if you have like oily acne prone, you can use oils, but I would recommend you still keep your routine of, you know, using cleansers and other products that do help exfoliate the pores, just so things are just not clogging up on top of each other and that you're, you know, cleaning your face pretty good. My skin right now is pretty acne prone and sensitive, so this definitely helps a lot with the sensitivity and calming the skin down. So I like it for that fact. Also, I like a bigger, broader synergistic blend of oils compared to the rosehip oil that they still have on their website. I've been using this for a few years now, and I would say the only difference is, well, this one has also rosehip oil in it and a whole bunch of other oils. This one's just rosehip. I feel like this one absorbs a little bit better on the skin than this one, especially for, you know, combination skin types. But this one's really nice too, but this one kind of kicks your butt, you know what I mean?
As you can see that the face oil has a few more ingredients than the body oil.
So I don't have anything to knock on the face oil. I love the packaging, glass, dropper. Oh, this is gonna last quite a while. Like I said, I caught myself wanting to use this like every single day. My oily people, you just wanna make sure you're getting those pores cleaned. My skin is pretty acne prone right now. My time of the month also, so I had a couple new friends show up.
On my face.
Well, hopefully that was a quick enough review. I'm gonna check back. So if you like the vibes, subscribe. Let me know what's on your mind. Leave me a comment and I'll catch you next time.